Despite being the creation of Sakurai himself, Kirby has been a low-tier character in almost every single Smash game. His simple, yet devastating combos let him shine in Smash 64. But ever since then, the pink puffball has fallen short due to weaknesses such as slow movement and lack of range. It's a shame we don't see more of Kirby, because he's the only character that actually can copy other people's moves in the entire game. Ever since Smash 64, Kirby's neutral special allows him to inhale another character, with the option to spit them back out or swallow them. If he swallows them, Kirby will don a hat matching the swallowed character's appearance, and he'll now be able to use their own version of their neutral special. This means that Kirby can use over 80 different neutral specials, and the effect this can have on Kirby range from completely useless to borderline broken. Hey, this is Keitaro, and in this video, we're going to go over our top 20 Kirby hats to determine which Kirby is the best Kirby. Before we dive into this though, we want to know in our question of the day, which Kirby hat is your favorite Kirby hat? Go ahead and tell us in the comments below, and be sure to keep watching to see who made the list. Before we get into that, you can learn plenty about Kirby on ProGuides.com. It's not just Kirby though, we have guides and tips for every single character in the game which you could check out on our tier list. You can also take advantage of our Player of Pros feature to get yourself a pro coach today, and check out our exclusive courses featuring top players such as MKLeo. So when it comes down to the best Kirby hats, there's a few things to keep in mind. Different power-ups can improve Kirby's neutral, advantage state, recovery, and even unlock new combos. Another important factor is that in a real singles match, Kirby will only be able to copy an ability if he's also fighting that character. Because of this, we're going to assess the abilities as they aid in their corresponding matchups and in general. First up, Samus and Dark Samus. Samus's charge shot is arguably the best charge ball projectile in the game, dealing 33 damage at full charge, starting combos, and taking stocks. Kirby's copy charge shot is even better. When fully charged, it deals a whopping 40% and can kill as early as 80%. It can also start low percent combos and give Kirby some additional aerial mix-ups with B reverses. Since Kirby has multiple double jumps, he can cancel out of the charge many times. In the Samus matchup, this ability is extremely useful, as Kirby has a very hard time approaching Samus. With charge shot, he can camp too and forces Samus to approach if he has the percent lead. Piranha Plant isn't the most common character in competitive Smash, but it does have one of the best neutral specials in the game. The Spike Ball, actually called Patui, gives Kirby a great mix-up and disadvantage that can be used to break combos or stall in the air. The ball does over 25% damage, and Kirby can use it to pressure his opponent without needing to approach and edgeguard without going off stage. As with Samus, Plant is a good character at zoning and keep away gameplay, so Kirby will have a much better time with a long-range option. Kirby can skip years of medical school to become a doctor. He could just swallow Dr. Mario. In doing so, Kirby gains access to Mega Vitamins, a great projectile that could be used to zone or start combos. Kirby can even link this into a forward smash for an early kill confirm, and the Wall of Pharmaceuticals acts as a great deterrent to a slow character like Doc. Dr. Kirby can certainly get things done, but I still wouldn't want him doing my surgery. Kirby may not be a kid nor a squid, but inhaling Inkling could give him the best of both. As with Inklings, Kirby's Splattershot will spray ink onto opponents that increases the power of his hits. This can be a great counter to Inkling's dash dance, and offers other shared benefits, such as pressuring shields and getting off the ledge. The only downside is that Kirby cannot charge his ink, and he'll lose the hat when it's depleted. Zelda's Neutral B is a popular rage inducer online, and Kirby can use it too! I'm not sure which Triforce piece Kirby possesses, but he has no problem using Nairu's Love to defend himself and reflect projectiles. Like Zelda, Kirby's Nairu's Love has intangibility frames, making it a great get-off-me option. In the Zelda matchup, Kirby can use this to protect himself from Din's fire as he recovers, reflect Zelda's Phantom, and two-frame her recovery. Kirby is too busy saving the universe to hit the gym, so he could just swallow Weefit Trainer instead. Sun Salutation is pretty similar to Samus's charge shot, but with one key difference. When it's fully charged, shooting this projectile will heal 2%. Weefit is a character who loves to slow matches down, but with a Kirby simultaneously projectile camping and healing, she might actually have to approach. Olimar might be the only character in Smash who is canonically smaller than Kirby, but Kirby can swallow things much bigger than himself either way. With Olimar's ability, Kirby actually obtains a combination of Olimar's neutral B and side B, plucking Pikmin from the ground and immediately tossing them forward. This is a great tool for zoning, edgeguarding, and ledge trapping, and significantly aids Kirby against Olimar's own onslaught of Pikmin. Young Link's Fire Arrow is one of the best projectiles in the game, and fortunately for Kirby, it's his neutral special. Although Kirby doesn't get the insane combos off of it like Young Link does, he can shoot many arrows at varying heights thanks to his multiple double jumps, turning Kirby into a capable zoner. As with other matchups, this will make it hard for an opposing Young Link to camp out Kirby once he has this ability. If Kirby could summon Arsene, this ability might actually be a shoo-in for the best. But Kirby can get a lot done with Joker's gun as well. He can pressure opponents from a distance in neutral as Joker does, and Kirby can use Joker's infamous down guns too. Especially since his weren't nerfed like Joker's, Kirby's down guns are great for landing, which Kirby struggles with, and they are great for an edgeguarding tool as well. Down guns are particularly great for gimping Joker's grappling hook recovery, so this ability is excellent to have in a Joker matchup. Kirby's copy abilities go further than just copying the move. In the case of Snake's grenade, Kirby even mimics how Snake protects his ears from the sound of the explosion. Snake's grenade is an amazing special move, and Kirby can take advantage of its strengths as well. With grenade, Kirby can play a completely different neutral, break out of combos, and start many new combos of his own. In the Snake matchup, this ability results in a chaotic scenario where four grenades can be on stage at once, but this also lets Kirby get in some damage without getting near Snake's traps. Whether you swallow Simon or Richter, Kirby will gain the axe throwing ability. At this point, it's quite clear that most of Kirby's best hats are other projectiles, and the Belmont's axe is no exception. Kirby's axe deals a whopping 21% and can start early percent combos. This also adds a great option to his edgeguarding and ledge trapping. As for the effects on the Belmont's matchup, this follows the same trend of letting Kirby camp back against a campy character. Wolf's laser is pretty simple. It's just a good, long-range projectile that changes the pace of the neutral game. Kirby's laser will do the exact same, and has slightly better frame data and damage output compared to Wolf's. Wolf can actually camp out Kirby pretty well with the laser and take advantage of his approaches, so this lets Kirby combat the strategy and create mix-up trees if Wolf tries reflecting the laser. Duck Hunt's can is a fantastic neutral tool that both defends Duck Hunt and starts many combos. Kirby can also start combos with this move, including kill confirms. Like Snake's grenade, the can explosion comes out extremely fast, so Kirby can use it to break combos. With carefully timed beat presses, this can also protect Kirby as he recovers. In the Duck Hunt matchup, Kirby's can can cover recovery options brilliantly, and of course the classic Kirby can camp back trend. Pac-Man's neutral B is bonus fruit, which lets him choose from many items with different abilities. Kirby can do the same, which opens up many possibilities. He can start great early percent combos with Galaxian Chip, confirm kills with the Bell, break zones with Ki, and much more. In the Pac-Man matchup, Kirby can use his fruits to break Pac-Man's Hydrant from a safe distance, and yet camp again back against another campy character. Incineroar's Dark Lariat has invincibility frames and can both break and end combos. The strong hit of Kirby's Lariat actually deals 25%, and he has a few ways to end combos with it as well. This move has decent knockback, so it can be an additional KO option for Kirby, and it's also great for edgeguarding thanks to his long active frames. This is especially good against Incineroar, as it can be used to safely challenge his poor recovery and gimp him. You might think that Peach and Daisy are the only two characters in Smash who could summon a Toad, but Kirby's stomach is basically an entire universe, so he must have one in there too. We're of course talking about Kirby's copy ability from Peach or Daisy, where he summons a Toad to counter enemies' attacks. Having a counter is always useful, and it can be a dangerous mix-up against aggressive opponents. Counters are also great to edgeguard recoveries with hitboxes, which makes this great in the Peach matchup. Without Toad counter, Kirby will have a lot of trouble edgeguarding Peach and Daisy, because their parasol protects them from his down air. Kirby's Toad is also a bit stronger, dealing 30%. When Kirby swallows Corrin, his appearance changes quite a bit, but he also obtains a Dragon Fang shot. At full charge, this move stuns opponents for long enough to easily confirm kills, and even an uncharged shot can combo into a partially charged bite to close out stocks. This gives Kirby an option to fight back against Corrin's disjointed moveset, which can otherwise give him some trouble. If the Meta Knight-inspired skin isn't edgy enough for you, swallowing Mr. Game & Watch will certainly give you the darkest form of Kirby, and he also learns to cook. With the Chef ability, Kirby can shut down some aerial approaches and ledge trap. Like Game & Watch, Kirby could combo the food particles into dash attack for ledge trap KOs. Since Game & Watch is easy to two-frame, this move is extra strong at the ledge in this matchup, and it can make finding nairs more difficult for Game & Watch in neutral. Similar to Corrin's Dragon Fang shot, Zero Suit Samus' paralyzer is a projectile that starts combos. Even half-charged, Kirby can combo this move into forward smash to confirm KOs. Paralyzer is also great for tech chases, which Kirby is pretty good at setting up for, and combined with the power of his F smash makes for a scary situation for a light character like Zero Suit. Now it's time for the best copy ability Kirby has, and as you might have guessed, it's Shulk's Monado Arts. With the Monado's power, Kirby can change his attributes just like Shulk. He can move extremely fast and perform new combos with speed art, deal tons of damage with Buster, take stocks even early with Smash, live forever with Shield, and scale any height with Jump. The potential for this is so diverse that it doesn't affect the Shulk matchup much differently from any other. It just makes Kirby a straight up much better character, and he's got a sword. So what's your favorite Kirby hat in Smash Ultimate? Let us know in the comments and make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications for more from ProGuides.